Hi, my name is Laurie Espers. I'm a teacher in a technical school in Belgium, and I teach mainly math and some hours building and construction. I start working on the citizen science project about air quality in my building lessons. It could be implemented very easily in my curriculum because air quality is one of the topics I have to discuss. In my lessons, I always try to get started practically with students as much as possible. So that was very nice to have some practical things to go into. It was also very nice to delve deeper into this topic in this corona time, because now it's air quality is a very hot item. And I think the students were also more interested in this topic. In this case, I worked together with the students of the last year's secondary education. So that was the sixth year industrial science. It is a strong scientific direction, and it is intended to progress to higher education. In total, we spent four times two lessons, so 4 weeks, two lessons on this subject. We started with several scientific experiments for which we received materials from the scientists. It was also very well arranged to send the materials from one school to another, and that was arranged by Britec. Because there were also live measurements in the classroom during 2 weeks, we could further link the small experiments in the beginning of our lessons to the real life, and integrate learning materials from the past years, formulas from other lessons. So that was very nice. Even though it was a strong scientific direction, it was not always easy to get the students to come up with their own strategies. I think they don't learn that enough in school, so it was a very good exercise now. They worked in small groups at their own pace, and that was a good class layout. I thought the conversation with the scientists added value, but I did not involve the students enough in this because I did not immediately have many questions myself for the scientists because I did not look at the subject broadly enough. I was only thinking about the project itself and not thinking about air quality in general, so I did not I didn't let my students prepare anything, and that was for me that was a missed opportunity. I experienced two major advantages. The first is the added value of coming into contact with other teachers who work around the same project, so we could share materials, and that was very enriching. And by extension, maybe we can share more materials from other lessons and subjects. And the second advantage is in our project, the learning scenario drawn up by the scientists was very nicely worked out, even up to test setups and things. So that was fantastic, and we were free to cut or add things so we could fully adapt it in our own wishes. I thought that in the end there was still a lot of work to do, but that's how it goes with new projects. And I do hope that we can use it again next school year, hopefully with the scientists or even without the scientists.
Hello, I am Wim van Buggenhout, and I teach at the school GTI Londerzeel in Belgium. The aim of the Citizen Science project is to collect data from the air quality in Flemish classroom, and it's a very hot topic, especially with COVID-19. Over here you can see when the lesson started, it starts in the morning, you see an increasing of carbon dioxide concentration. It drops when we are going to eat, and when the lesson starts again in the afternoon, you see again an increase of the carbon dioxide. Here you see the carbon dioxide sensor. We started with an online lesson by Dr. Ingenieur Architect Geert Bouwens of the KU Leuven. He explained many practical cases of his research, and our students were very interested because it was very concrete and our students liked it. We also had developed our own project in the previous year, and it's called Butterflies Small and Big. I will explain this to you now. The University of Ghent launched a citizen science project called Vlinder. And together with 60 other schools, we were selected to build a prefab weather station, which you see over here. We placed it at a very particular place. Here you see the different, every dot is a weather station placed in the Flemish part of Belgium. And we placed our station at a very particular place in the center of a lake. It was quite an experience to do this with the students. We made a template for the students with all the exercises, and they had to make a comparison between two weather stations. For example, one station compared the weather parameters of our own station with the station which was placed, for example, in the center of our capital in Brussels. Here you see that the comparison of the temperature of two weather stations. At the end, they had to make a scientific poster in English, which illustrates that our project is more than STEM, because we include all languages and the scientific research method. This project was called the Big Butterfly. But parallel to this, we came up with a broader, small butterfly. And there, students made their own device, so that they could measure temperature, humidity, carbon dioxide, fine dust, etc. in several classrooms in order to compare our new building, which is a passive building, with an older part of our school building. Our own butterfly project has a perfect match with the Brightec project, air quality and temperature in classroom. And therefore, I will explain this, how we did this in our class. We started with an experiment where we measured the carbon dioxide concentration in our classroom, and also measured the carbon dioxide concentration of the exhaust of some students. Two students do research on different kind of carbon dioxide sensor for their integrated task. As a scientific research, they did measurements with the Brightec sensor in four classrooms of our school. During 2 weeks, they measured in our classroom in the old building, which is traditionally built without any ventilation system, and a classroom in our new building, which is a passive building with a ventilation system with heat recovery. 1 week, they did it in two rooms on the ground floor, the other week, two classrooms on the first floor. And I can explain you a little bit about the results. Here you see the limit of 1400 ppm. You can't exceed that value, but you see in the older building, we exceed this value at a regular base. The passive building is perfect in order, because we stay enough below that upper limit. For the practical part of their integrated task, they analyze four different carbon dioxide sensors, which they will program with Arduino. Once these sensors are operational and the students have designed a suitable housing, they use them to do measurements and compare the quality of their own sensor with a professional Brightec sensor. Two other students are creating a weather station that will be placed at our school. They have to engineer the whole device, program the sensor, and program the communication with Internet of Things. That the students work with real data with a Brightec sensor and make their own device leads to very high motivation. As a general conclusion, I can say that all my classes were into Brightec, and thanks to Brightec, we could see meteors, we could smell carbon dioxide, and we could hear quite strange sounds. We are very glad that we got in touch with Brytek, and it tastes like more Brytek. Thank you for your attention.